The committee of experts is currently locked up at the Great Rift Valley Lodge in Naivasha, working on its initial draft of the constitution. But the exercise was marred by a stirring letter by one of its members, Njoki Ndung'u, in some accusing the committee of failing the transparency test. Njoki boycotted the Naivasha drafting retreat, alleging that it was premature since there had not been adequate consultations. But the committee chairman maintains there's nothing to worry about.
That Honorable Njoki Ndung'u was present and endorsed the retreat on 14th September this year. It does not mean that if one member has taken a different view from the committee, that the committee has become disjointed, derailed, and so forth.
With the new intrigues facing the committee and raising more suspicion of infighting among its members, stakeholders are now worried that efforts of resolving the contentious issues might hit a snag.
There are individuals and groups who are not keen on a new constitution and who therefore place all possible obstacles to frustrate the process. The committee continues to transact business despite that unfortunate decision by the Honorable Njoki Ndung'u.
But yesterday, a host of political parties, among them KANU, supported Njoki's position.
Consult them, but don't call people to a one-day workshop, tell them positions, because that is good. That is not good to give us a consensus.
The committee says that in 1 month's time, it will have come up with a draft which will still be open to changes for 30 days before it is gazetted, tabled in parliament for debate, and then taken to Kenyans for a referendum. With 5 months remaining before Kenyans get a new constitution, as promised by the Grand Coalition government, obstacles and hurdles have already started hindering the process. But undeterred, the committee of experts says that in less than 1 month, they're going to deliver one draft. Chris Dairu, Citizen TV, Naivasha.